This is our annual Christmas pageant, and it's the same story every year because it's a beautiful story of God's salvation for us. And every year we have something interesting happen. This year I think significant was we have a brand new second grade teacher, and she had to step in, and this is a huge project. Especially since all of the second graders have the principal parts. And so it was really a huge endeavor for her, but marvelously done is good, and it has come together, and we're going to enjoy it. I tell the children every year that this is their gift to you. And so all the work that they've done and the practicing and the excitement all day long, and that I'm sure they've expressed at home too, is actually a gift to you this Christmas season. And it's a nice way to during the time of Advent, for us to prepare our hearts for the celebration of Christmas. So enjoy, and we enjoy your students, your children rather, as our students, who are so talented.
The warnings of those prophets were undercut by false shepherds, so gave one of God's greatest promises to his wayward people, given late in Israel's history through the prophet Ezekiel. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph in the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary.
And you will
in Hastings, town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit, and she exclaimed with a loud cry,
"Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, and why conceived is the mother of my Lord God unto me?
My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior."
Now this is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about, when his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph. But before they lived together, she was found with child through the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her husband, since he was a righteous man, yet unwilling to expose her to shame, decided to divorce her privately. Such was his intention when, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet, "Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel."
Thank you. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be enrolled. And all went to be enrolled, each to his own city. Joseph went up to Bethlehem with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child.
And while they were there, the time came for her to be delivered, and she gave birth to her son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn.
Thank you. And in that region, there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And the angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, and suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying,
glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men who
Thank you.
knowing Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king. Behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem. When they had heard the king, they went their way, and lo, the star, which they had seen in the east, went before them till it came to rest over the place where the child was. And going into the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. Treasures, they offered him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Thank you.
going to the world. Mary, I love when you raised baby Jesus up in the air as you sang, "Oh come, let us adore him." That was perfect because we're here to adore him. And as we were watching after the infant was born, I heard a little voice behind me, and I don't know who it was, but I heard a little voice behind me saying, "I want to see baby Jesus. I want to see baby Jesus." And I thought, don't we all? Isn't that the essence of what we're celebrating at Christmas? We want to see baby Jesus. And I think for those of us who have the joy and privilege of being with your children every day, that is part of what makes it such a beautiful thing that we get to do, to spend time with these beautiful children who are seeking Jesus with their whole hearts. So thank you for being here with us to share with us tonight. We have some very special thank yous we need to make, because this doesn't happen without any work at all. It happens with a great deal of work. So we have special gifts to thank the teachers involved. Mrs. Twelman is the beautiful show together, and it just moves me every year. And Sister Teresa Paul, our kindergarten teacher, guided us. Because of an assignment change, has only been with us, I think, 6 weeks. And yet, her second graders were the ones who pulled off all of the leading roles in tonight's performance. It's a great show. And of course, there's also a good amount of behind-the-scenes work that happens. And I want to thank Mrs. Peters, our stage manager for the production tonight, who did a tremendous. And of course, can we have one more round of applause for our kindergarten first class?